Upper Echelon is brought to you by Deloitte. For innovative thinking and thorough strategic planning, turn to Deloitte. Benjamin Mofatlani, the chief executive of BCX, is with us in the Upper Echelon this day. And Ben, it's interesting to go back. You've been an entrepreneur, for pretty much your whole business career. One would have thought that running such a big company now is quite a long way away from your entrepreneurial roots. But was that what you always wanted to do, become perhaps a entrepreneur stroke professional manager?
Thanks, Alec. I mean, it's been an exciting journey. In fact, I was saying to my twin brother the other day that it's actually been 15 years that I've been associated with Business Connection. When we started the business was 1st September 96. It's been an exciting journey. I've learned a lot. I must admit, I'm learning all the time. It's been an exciting because it's given me an ability to have a profile, to exercise my entrepreneurial spirit, but at the same time to be part of the South African corporate culture.
What did you start it as in 96? What was Business Connection?
We started as Business Connection. I just left the articles after 6 months with KPMG. I had graduated from University of Pretoria with an accounting degree, and there was an opportunity within the Connection Group to start an empowerment company that will sell into parastatals and public sector. And the first thing we really cut our teeth into was selling Microsoft licenses. And we're a very small business. Connection Group made us a seed capital of 4 million rand.
Was that Incredible Connection?
It's Incredible Connection now, but it was actually Connection Group. If you recall, they're currently being the part of the JD Group currently, but the original funders to the business were actually the Connection Group, which was then Software Connection.
Was it Philip Cowles or was it?
It was Philip Cowles, Paul Moses, Pierre Hubert, later on as well, and I think they had Gordon Mulholland as a chairman. Stephen Mulholland.
Not the actor, sorry.
That Stephen Mulholland as a chairman. Mm-hmm. The business started in 96, and we're very small, focused on providing and selling licenses and Microsoft infrastructure to parastatals. Then in 99, a Connection Group went through its troubles. Then we're fortunate to get a global firm in the form of Getronix, and they bought into the business to get 50% share, paid the money that was owed to the Connection Group. Then they themselves ran into trouble, but it was an incredible learning experience because it allowed us to be part of a global firm. Then we subsequently merged in 2001 with a company called Seattle Solutions and made us the biggest Microsoft partner in terms of software licenses, in terms of infrastructure rollout. We had over 300 skills of Microsoft. The Seattle boys were very much guys who were based out of Cape Town and Durban. It gave us quite a nice spread and our ability to cover the country. And as we grew, 2003, started having a chat with Peter Watt, who was the CEO of Comprex. Comprex were looking for an empowerment partner, but an operational one as well. So we're able to flip our business very much into Comprex, and the business became Business Connection.
It's been an incredible story from a little start with what became a very troubled retailing group or company that was retailing computers to where you are today, which is a million miles away.
Very much. I mean, I didn't even think in the wildest imagination that the business would be the size. I mean, we're now close to 6,000 people, very much on the continent. But it's been phenomenal, no doubt about it.
What drew you to technology in particular?
I was fortunate, Alec, that I went to school, my twin brother and I, Isaac, where we're fortunate to attend Christian Brothers College in Kimberley in 1986, during those, tough years.
But dark years.
Yeah, very much. And we're exposed to computers at that stage. There was a computer club at school, and we actually wanted to be part of the computer club, and it was our first experience with computers. In those days, it was actually the BBC microcomputer. So the school had that, and we really kind of fell in love with the technology side of it and almost became the geeks, as you may imagine, in those days.
And it's moved along to what you're doing right now in running a very big business. Since you took over from Peter Watt in June 2007, it hasn't been the easiest of times.
No, it hasn't been the easiest of times, but I think credit to the business. I think we've got an incredibly, what I call a resilient business. Our service delivery, you know, most people always think Business Connection has got a lot of public sector revenue. public sector only accounts to 15-16%. A lot of the blue chip clients, you know, prefer Business Connection as a service provider of choice. And I think it's because our people deliver on a day-to-day incredible amount of service. You know, once we've got a client, we very look at that. It's had its ups and downs. I think no doubt about it, but no doubt about it, it's been an incredible learning experience.
It is interesting because one would have thought as a black CEO, you would have had a better opportunity in the public sector, but that doesn't seem to be the case.
Well, I think technology also, I must admit, people want things that work. You know, we run a lot of very complex data centers on our behalf of our clients, especially with our cloud offering. And most of the corporates, I must admit, when I engage with them, the first thing they always talk about is service delivery. As long as you guys are delivering a service, and it's more important. I think my disappointment, I guess, maybe from our perspective that our dealings with government haven't been as great as we'd wish. I would want to see government actually adopt technology because some of our service delivery issues in this country are very much linked to the fact that government cannot provide the services because technology is not there. And my biggest worry as a South African is that we're lagging behind countries like Kenya, Rwanda, on the African continent who are late adopters of technology. So we'd love to see more government spending. We'd like to be more streamlined. We'd like to see more transparent. And we'd like to be done without, you know, controversy either.
Why are you not cracking it?
Well, you know, I think, you know, we're very clear in terms of what we deliver in government. And we're not going to be, we don't necessarily go after every tender as well. And also at the same time, I think that we've got a very clear policies in terms of how we want to engage with government. And sometimes it doesn't always work out the way it does. I think that most people find us quite a difficult, but I don't think we're difficult. I think we stick to our guns. You know, we believe that we've got the capability. We still continue to run the payroll for the South African government. We run ERP systems for municipalities that work. So we believe that, you know, our offering is unique, but at the same time, you know, we're not necessarily going to do every single project because some of the projects can become the death knell for a company.
If one talks to the average white businessman in South Africa, they would say, geez, Ben, you're in a brilliant situation. You're in the right place at the right time from the right background. But there are also other challenges that are brought to bear on black businessmen in South Africa, challenges that your white counterparts have got no clue. For instance, talking on this program just a little while ago, there was a concern raised by one of the leading black entrepreneurs in the country that you're perceived in, or businesses perceived in the, amongst most South Africans as being the enemy. In fact, labor is perceived as being the good guys. What do you make of all that?
Look, there's no doubt about it. I think one of the biggest challenges for us as a country, the relationship between government and business hasn't been the greatest. I mean, you can just look at it. I think that maybe that's one thing that has to work on because you've got to have a levels of trust. You know, we're finding ourselves in a global crisis. We're finding ourselves in some very difficult and volatile situations. And when you go through tough times, it's actually more, trust has got to be more important. I think it's important that business engages government, but also at the same time, I think the government must be consistent when they engage with business. I think that where we lose hope or we actually get frustrated is when you don't get the levels of consistency and you actually don't get the same, you get mixed signals coming out of government, you know, especially in the areas that we are. We want to make sure that ultimately that levels of relationship, I think that it's gone in the last maybe 3-5 years, it's actually fluctuated. I think possibly this is not the best stage that the relationship between government and business is at its lowest levels.
Is there a role to be played there by the BMF, the Black Management Foundation?
I believe that, you know, the Black Management Forum, and very much all the organizations, the first thing we all have to put is that we've got to put South Africa first. Because currently, as much as anywhere, South Africa is perceived as seen as a gateway to Africa. There's a level of competition on the continent. We're no longer going to become the preferred darling that used to be. People are looking at Mozambique as a different avenues of participating. I mean, you just have to look at what happened with DBS announcing, you know, today that most of the work that will come from 2013 into Botswana. So I think it's important that, you know, yes, we are in a very well positioned, but I think it's important for us to realize that whichever forum you might belong to organization, it's got to be about South Africa. It's also got to be about creating jobs for South Africans.
If you look back in 10 years' time, perhaps that's a bit short for someone of your youth, maybe 20 years' time, What would you like your legacy to be at BCX and indeed for the country?
Well, I mean, for us, the we still believe the prize is out there. I think MTN has done incredibly well as a South African firm that has become African. And for an IT service provider like Business Connection, the ultimate prize is to become the most pan-African, employing people across the continent, anywhere else, and moving skills, and actually making sure that part of this organization has improved the levels of skills, the levels of technology, and South Africa is in a better place from a technology point of view.
How much progress have you made towards that dream?
I think we've made a lot of progress. I mean, we're possibly one of the biggest employers. People don't realize. With the two acquisitions we did this year of UCS and Canon, we employ over 6,000 people. In Mozambique, we've seen possibly the growth in terms of the amount of people that we employ, which means, and the Mozambicans, which means that we're becoming more and more an African player as opposed to being a South African player.
So where's next on the continent?
Well, I think that there's no doubt about it. Ghana offers opportunities. We're not there. We want Zimbabwe to improve. We believe that Zimbabwe's got an incredible amount of education and skills. So the people there are ripe for opportunities. Angola is one area. Because if one looks at Africa, I mean, both South Africa and Nigeria account for 51% of the GDP. The other 65% is South Africa, Angola, Kenya, and Nigeria. We're already in Nigeria. We're excited about Nigeria.
Ben, when you get up in the morning and go to work, what is it that keeps you happy? What keeps you skipping all the way to the office?
I think the people that I work with, I think we've got an incredible talented people. I mean, we believe, especially when, I said to somebody last week, I possibly had one of my best weeks, and they say, why? I said, I went to presentations where we're presenting to large corporates, South African corporates, and our people had put up this amazing presentation showing their skills and our capability. Everybody went, I think that excites me, our capability that, one of the few things we do is that we're the first IT services company to have a tier 4 data center on the continent, which it's incredible. Corporates trust us. And I think that's what actually excites me, seeing our people deliver a great service on a day-to-day basis. I mean, I guess it's very much part of the connective intelligence.
I know the chief executives are not supposed to look at the share prices, but yours has been it's had a topsy-turvy run. From touching 7 Rand in November last year, it came all the way down to 4.50 a month ago, but it's now up to 5.30. Still a long way from where you started the year. Why do you think it is that you've gone out of favor like this?
Well, I think, we had I think that the first half of the year was a very incredibly difficult half year, and very much on the basis that a large of the big corporates were not rolling out big of the projects. The technology refreshes were not coming out. But I think since then, we're starting to see an improvement. I think the important part, unfortunately, we're trading under a cautionary, so I guess part of the movement is going on is because we are trading under cautionary.
There was a time when, in fact, just before you took over, talking about trading under a cautionary, where it looked like BCX was going to become part of Telkom.
Yes.
That deal didn't go through. Looking back on it now, was that a blessing?
Well, I think, going back, I mean, I've always said, it was actually a good learning experience. It was a blessing for two reasons. One, it made our people incredibly unhappy because they were going into a very uncertain future. Telkom was going through a lot of leadership crisis. And secondly, when you speak to customers post the event, most of the customers were not sure if they wanted to remain with Business Connection. And going forward, I always believe that, one always has to do a deal that is good for our shareholders, is good for our staff, is good for management, and is good for our clients. And if those four criteria are very much ticked, you got a great deal. I think that Telkom has proven that, they had to go through a lot of transformation and a lot of changes, and it was just not the right time, I guess, for that. And I think the tribunal had fears that Telkom might actually end up being the good person who said they were going to be and end up something else. And I think that was a challenge. But the world has changed. I think the convergence of IT services company and telcos is happening all the time.
Interesting future that beckons for Business Connection and its chief executive, Benjamin Mofatlani. Upper Echelon was brought to you by Deloitte. For innovative thinking and thorough strategic planning, turn to Deloitte.